Hi everyone, this is Kalyan Kumar and welcome back to Product Review. The iPhone 12 series was unveiled by Apple at its virtual event on Tuesday, the 13th of October 2020. And it consists of the iPhone 12 mini, iPhone 12, iPhone 12 Pro and the iPhone 12 Pro Max. While the iPhone 12 mini comes as the smallest and the most affordable model in the new series, the iPhone 12 is designed as the successor to the iPhone 11, and the iPhone 12 Pro and the iPhone 12 Pro Max are projected as the successors to the iPhone 11 Pro and iPhone 11 Pro Max. All four models in the 2020 iPhone lineup come with 5G support and are powered by the Apple's A14 Bionic chip. The latest models also run an iOS 14 out of the box and retain the notch that was featured originally on the iPhone 10 in November 2017. The dual SIM, that is Nano plus eSIM, iPhone 12 mini, the iPhone 12, iPhone 12 Pro and the 12 Pro Max run on iOS 14 and come with Super Retina XDR OLED displays. Also featuring a ceramic shield glass car on top. This is a significant upgrade from last year's iPhone launch, as the iPhone 11 in the 2019 iPhone range was launched with an LCD panel instead of an upgraded OLED screen. The new models are also powered by the A14 Bionic SoC that is already available on the latest iPad Air and comes with the 4th generation neural engine. The A14 Bionic is designed to handle tasks including 4K video editing. It is also claimed to deliver 50% boost in CPU performance and 30% improvement in graphics over the existing A13 Bionic chip. Further, the new 16-core neural engine is touted to be capable of performing up to 11 trillion operations per second. There are also second-generation machine learning accelerators in the CPU to provide 10% faster machine learning calculations over the previous generation neural engine. Apart from the enhanced processing power, the 2020 iPhone family comes with 5G support. It is, however, of no use if 5G networks are yet to be available in your area. The used variants of the iPhone 12 series also come with support for faster mmWave 5G networks. In terms of differences, the iPhone 12 mini comes in a 5.4 inch size, while the iPhone 12 and the iPhone 12 Pro share the same 6.1 inch form factor, and the iPhone 12 Pro Max is the biggest in the series with a 6.7 inch size. The iPhone 12 mini and the iPhone 12 feature 12 megapixel dual rear cameras that include a wide-angle and an ultra wide angle shooter with f1.6 aperture and f2.4 aperture respectively. The iPhone 12 Pro and the 12 Pro Max, on the other hand, offer 12 megapixel triple rear cameras with a wide f1.6, ultra wide f2.4, and an additional telephoto f2.0 on the Pro and f2.2 on the Pro Max lens. They also include a LiDAR, a portmanteau of light and radar scanner for better autofocus in low light and night mode portraits, improved depth photography, and augmented reality measurements. The iPhone 12 Pro Max also carries a 47% larger wide camera sensor. The iPhone 12 Pro offers 4x optical zoom, while the iPhone 12 Pro Max offers 5x optical zoom with the telephoto sensor. All models feature 12 megapixel f2.2 front cameras. The company is also rolling out a new Apple Pro RAW format on the iPhone 12 Pro and the Pro Max, giving users a professional post photography experience. Apart from the Photos app, third-party apps will be able to use the new image format thanks to an API. The Pro iPhone 12 models also offer 4K Dolby Vision HDR video recording and on-device editing of the result. Apple has also improved its Deep Fusion software tweak that was debuted on the iPhone 11 Pro and iPhone 11 Pro Max last year. Similarly, the night mode on the iPhone 12 series has also been updated to deliver better low light results, including by the front camera also. A night mode time-lapse feature will also be launched soon. In terms of battery life, the iPhone 12 mini is claimed to deliver up to 15 hours of video playback, while the iPhone 12 is rated to offer up to 17 hours video playback, the same as the iPhone 12 Pro. The iPhone 12 Pro Max is projected to deliver the longest battery life in an iPhone with up to 20 hours of video playback. All of them support MagSafe wireless charging at up to 15 watts and Qi wireless charging at about 7.5 watts. Apple has also offered upgraded wireless charging support on the iPhone 12 series that supports magnetic chargers carrying the MagSafe branding, which was earlier associated with the magnetically charging accessories in previous generation of MacBooks. MagSafe on the iPhone 12 series is enabled thanks to housing of a magnet and charging array within the phone case itself. Notably, the iPhone 12 series will be shipped without an AC adapter in the box. It comes with a USB-C to Lightning cable, and the decision to remove the charger from the box has been claimed to be for environmental reasons. But just one issue that I have is that none of the previous adapter or any other iPhone adapter or any other phone adapter can be used with a charging cable provided. Because the charging cable is Lightning to USB-C. All normal phone chargers have USB-A at the adapter end. You would either need an adapter which has USB-C port on it, which is not common, or charge it with a computer, or use a previous iPhone cable with adapter. And has this environmental change benefit been passed on to the customer? I guess we will never know. This is the pricing model of all iPhone 12 series phones with different storage capacities. The second column features the pricing in India, both in rupees and dollars. The third column features the pricing in the US along with its rupee equivalent. And the last column is the extra duty and taxes you pay if you buy these phones in India. Now, if you look at the last two phones, the iPhone 12 Pro Max 256 and 512 gigs version, you could buy one of these phones in the US and also buy a OnePlus 8 Pro for the same price as one of these in India would cost. Seriously, I would never recommend anyone buying these phones in India. Now, in my opinion, the duty is so high, is so heavy, it is absolutely ridiculous. Paying this much amount of money, $58,000 for what? For a phone, which is almost half the cost of the phone itself, perhaps even more than that. And this kind of a duty is definitely not done. But what it will do, it will encourage, is it will ask people to ask other people coming from the US to bring these phones to India. Once, of course, the flights resume, and which is not a big deal. You just have to buy a phone in the US, unpack it, unbox it, take out the phone, and you know, put in the Apple ID, and when you come here, show it to the customs, and that too, and you're through. And that is the problem, because what will also happen is if you don't have anybody coming in, you always go to the gray market. So I believe that with this iPhone 12 launch, we will see a greater number of iPhone 12s being sold in the gray market than those being sold in the retail stores, because the pricing is too skewed. It doesn't simply work. Now, pre-orders for the iPhone 12 and the iPhone 12 start October 16 in the US, UK, Japan, Germany, China, and Australia before going on sale on 23rd of October. In India, South Korea, and 12 other countries, the iPhone 12 and the 12 Pro will go on sale from October 30. The 12 Mini and the 12 Pro Max will go up for pre-orders starting November 6th in the US, with availability set for November 13th. The Indian availability for iPhone 12 Mini and the iPhone 12 Pro Max has yet to be detailed. Now, that was a quick look of the Apple keynote on the iPhone 12 series. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did making it. Have a nice day ahead, and thank you for watching.